from San Francisco, California. This is the Rock and Roll Geek Show.
This is the story of my rock and roll butler.
Welcome to the Rock and Roll Geek Show. My name's Michael Butler. Thanks a lot for joining me. I really appreciate it. Today is Tuesday, August 29th, and it is 8:31 p.m. when I'm recording this show. I am walking in the woods in Blue Ridge, Georgia. I just came back from a long day fishing trip on a boat on the Hiawassee River. We were on a drift boat, and we were fly fishing for several miles. We were there from, well, we met the guy at 9 a.m. and probably got on the water probably about 10, and we were on the water till 7 p.m. Fly fished all day, and I had never fly fished before, and man, let me tell you, it is very difficult. Didn't have any luck with the fish, but had a great time. It was beautiful out there, and I had no reception. And I got finally, when we got back to town where the guy dropped us off, we got to John, my stepdad's truck, and I finally got reception, and my phone blew up. And one of the things that came up on my phone was a message from Chris Sinzak, who put on the Rockin' Pod Expo, and saying something to the effect of, on the last episode, it seemed like I had a really shitty time at the expo, and it was a waste of my time. And apparently I came off like I didn't like this thing, and if that is the case, I didn't listen to the last episode that I posted with David Brewington. I was probably being, I really need to censor myself, because my fucking big mouth gets me into so much trouble, man. I gotta think before I talk. I didn't know that I said anything bad about this thing, because first of all, I want to make it completely clear that I had a blast at this Rockin' Pod Expo. This Chris Sinzak guy, he does the Decibel Geek podcast, and he put this podcast, this thing together called the Rockin' Pod Expo, all rock music podcasts, and he pretty much did all the work himself, lined up vendors, lined up the venue, took care of everybody's plane accommodations and hotels. I do not know how one guy can do all this. That guy went so far out of his way to put this thing on, and then for some asshole that does a Rock and Roll Geek Show podcast to come on a podcast and say anything bad about this thing, that is a dick move. And I hope I didn't say anything bad about it. I don't remember what I said. Maybe I said it was a circle jerk, but all podcast events are circle jerks. It's everybody patting each other on the back. But hey, there's nothing wrong with a circle jerk, and I believe I probably said that. So I just want to make a public retraction here to clear the air that this event was a smashing success. You had a room full of podcasters, full of really good record vendors that had a lot of rare vinyl, and I got a really cool Van Halen t-shirt there. The guy who wrote the Van Halen, one of the Van Halen books, which book is it? Not the one by Noel Monk, but the other guy. I can't remember the name of the book off the top. See, here I go again. I'm coming off as a dick, but I don't mean to come off as a dick, because the guy who wrote that Van Halen book was super nice to me and came up to me and was very complimentary to me and my podcast, and here I am, an asshole, do not remember the name of the book because I am just fried and can't think of it. So to everybody that I ever offend with just me talking off the top of my head on my podcast, I apologize, but I want to make it clear again that this Rockin' Pod Expo was a really good event, and Chris Sinzak knocked this thing out of the park by putting this thing on. Had a great time. You know, I maybe felt a little bit out of place, and maybe I was upset about getting there late and there being no table for me to set up. But again, that's my own fault because I showed up late, which I will probably go into it more on Mad at Dad, when the next Mad at Dad episode, but it was my own fault that I didn't have a table. If I would have got there early, I could have made a claim to a table. But I had a great time at this thing. Met some really cool people. All these other podcasts were very nice to me. I was probably not as nice to them as I should have been, because I'm a super shy guy in public. Very introverted, and I come off probably a little bit more dicky than I do, than I really mean to. So just want to clarify that. Ken Mills was a great guy. I met Ken Mills, super nice guy. I met BJ Cramp, another super nice guy. Everybody who I met at this thing was just a stand-up person. I can't say enough nice things about everybody who was there. The only person who wasn't nice that was there was probably me, because I was stuck in my own little world. And all right, enough of that. Rockin' Pod Expo. I hope Chris Sinzak does it again. I can't imagine that he would want to, because it just seems like so much work. But it seemed like it was well attended. The guy from Nelson was there. Mark Slaughter was there. Walter Egan was there. A lot of these people I'm not a fan of, but hey, doesn't mean anybody else is not a fan of them, because I like what I like. What can I say? All right. Well, anyway, Rockin' Pod Expo. Was a success. 2017. Everybody who put the thing on, Chris Sinzak mainly, kudos to you, my friend. All right, enough of this. I'm going to close this thing out because I'm a little bit tired, and I'm a little bit kind of bummed out that I came off like a dick. Again, came off like a dick. All right, apologies to Nashville, Tennessee, once again. I've offended the people of Nashville. All right, I spun the iTunes wheel, and up came a Phil Lynott solo song, Ode to Liberty, the protest song from the Phil Lynott album. I'll talk to you tomorrow, friends, with day 31 of the Dog Days of Podcasting. This thing's almost over. Tomorrow, I'm going to be going fishing again, and then we head to Jacksonville to go kayak fishing, hopefully. And hopefully I'll see some old friends when I'm in Jacksonville. All right, I'm gonna walk around the woods and listen to some more crickets. Here's Phil, and I'll talk to you tomorrow, friends. Stating the obvious, this is a bull.
The Statue of Liberty has a pretty honest fall. Give me your poor, give me your needy, give me them all. We need something like this for this world to coexist. It would be so easy to act so pretentious, to act as if it was hypocrisy. Inside my coat, it's a pistol that I pack. We must beware of a surprise nuclear attack. We must be ready to strike back. I'm not pretending. Our defense is thinly landing. We must keep on standing. Forget the third world is ending. It's crying. It's desolate. It's oh so late.
It's a rock and roll geek train wreck.